Hey everyone, this is Eric with Upton Base, and we're just about to start the restoration of a Prescott base that we got in about a year or 2 years ago. I don't know, it's been sitting in the back of the shop for a while, and it's time we do something with it. So next week we're going to start ripping it apart, seeing how bad it is on the inside. Like to say, it couldn't be worse than what you see on the outside, but it probably is. Now, throughout this region, there was I've heard a few names floated around, but there's someone a long time ago who was replacing the backs on these with a laminated back. It's hard to tell in there, but there's a lamination back there. Now, someone suggested to me that the original back was just thinned out and then sandwiched between two new layers of wood. I don't know if I believe that, but anything's possible, I suppose. It just sounds like a lot of work. It's such a weird thing to do. But we think we're going to leave the back. You know, it's not original to the base, so, you know, I could put a new back on it, but it just looked like a new back. This is a replaced back, but it was replaced, you know, a while ago. So it kind of patinaed, and I don't know, it matches in some ways. Sounds strange to say, but so I don't know if we're gonna replace the back or not. That's kind of up in the air. We're thinking not, but we could be influenced. Nice bassetto shape. Nice sloping upper shoulders. The F holes have all been cut. You can see that there's some jagged lines in there, and they're too irregular. Top needs a lot. It's got some arching distortions that need to be taken care of. Lots of cracks. You can see clear through it. You can put your business card through a few of these. The color is fantastic in some spots. Rib assembly needs to be completely gone through. They're actually not that bad. The lower bout is kind of messed up on the bottom down near the block. But put a new block in it, we can fix that up. It's gonna need a scroll graft. I mean, it's got all sorts of stuff going on here. Lots of heroic efforts. It wouldn't be the first time it had a scroll graft. You can see lines where it's had it grafted in the past. Cheek grafts, so the stinger plates are off. It's going to need new cheek grafts. We got some missing wood that's going to need to be grafted in there. This big clunky scroll. Cool detailing, huh? So, anyways, here it is. Just wanted to do a nice flyby on it before we start ripping it apart. So, when I do the next video, and it's all nice and purdy and sounding good, I can say, look how bad it used to look. Now, the cool thing is, flip over here, this Prescott. This is like the second best sounding bass I've ever heard. It's just incredible. But this bass was restored by Jeff Bobluck down in Long Island. And supposedly, he says, when this bass came into him, it was brought in a trash bag. He did have to replace the back. It had one of those plywood backs on it as well. He replaced the back. This one's kind of funky one. Got one of those church viol scrolls. Anyways, so this bass is gorgeous, sounds incredible. I mean, this one's just to die for. So hopefully, this will give us the same results. So it's kind of before and after. That's what I'm hoping for. Alrighty, be fun to watch this one. I'll probably do a bunch of videos or pictures up on stringrepair.com. If you haven't checked out stringrepair.com, check it out. There's tons of stuff on there. It's been stagnant for a while, but I'm going to get back into it. I'm kind of behind the scenes working on a new site for it, so about to give it some fresh life. But check out stringrepair.com. It's just a photo blog of all the repairs that we used to do. Like I said, been a little stagnant with it, but maybe this will get me back into it. All right, everyone. See you later. Bye-bye.